Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in today's biology session we are going to start our new lesson, and the name of the lesson is what? Reproduction in plants. Okay, so in this lesson we are going to discuss that how the plants are showing the reproduction process, or which are the different ways by that the plants are showing the reproduction. Okay, so before going to start the lesson, let's revise what is mean by reproduction. The production of new individuals from their parent is known as reproduction. Okay, so what is mean by the reproduction? So the production of new individuals from their parents, and that process is known as what? Reproduction. So in this particular lesson we are going to discuss about the reproduction in plants, means how the plants give rise to the new plants, or give rise, or how the plants are getting developed from the old plant. That only we are calling as what? Reproduction. So basically the plants are getting reproduced with the help of the different types. So let's discuss the first point, that is what? Modes of reproduction, means how the plants are getting reproduced with the help of the different processes, or with the help of the different methods. Before that, in your last standard or in the sixth standard, you have discussed about the parts of a plant. You have discussed about the deeply about roots, stem, leaves. Okay, also you have discussed about the buds, nodes which are present on the stem. So all these are the parts of a plant which are called as what? Vegetative parts. Okay, all these parts of a plant are called as what? Vegetative parts of a plant. But these vegetative parts of a plant also helps to reproduce the plant. Okay, so that we are going to see in the next session. So now all these roots, stem and the leaves, all are the vegetative parts of a plant. It means what? They helps the plant to grow. Okay, they helps the plants to grow. But along with all these parts, there is a one more part, that is what? Flowers, which is very beautiful, very pretty, and very important parts of a plant. Okay, so this flower is not help, or this flower is doesn't get used for the vegetative growth. Okay, but this flower plays a vital role in the process of reproduction. Okay, in the process of reproduction. Why? Because might be you have seen that if there is a some fruit for trees are there in here in your house, then you have seen that first the trees are bearing the flowers, and after that the flowers get converted into the fruit. Okay, so it means what? The flower helps to produce the fruits, which helps to produce the seed, and with the help of that seed we can grow the new plants. So it means what? The flower is a very important part of plant, which helps in the process of reproduction, and that is the reason the flowers are called as reproductive organ, reproductive part of a plant. Okay, the flower is called as what? Reproductive part of a plant. Okay, so these flowers might be, sometimes the flower contain both the male part and the female part. Okay, means both the reproductive organ, it can contain the male reproductive organ also, and can contain the female reproductive organ also. But in other cases, what we can say, that the flower might be contain only male reproductive organ or only female reproductive organ. Okay, so two cases will be there. In the first case is what we can say, that the flower contains both the male and the female reproductive organ in the flower. And in the second case, what we can say, either it contain male reproductive organ or either it contain female reproductive organ. Okay, so it is very important thing, it is a keyword that you have to keep in your mind, that is what? The flower is known as what? Reproductive organ of a plant, or reproductive part of a plant. Okay, so according to that, the basically the plants are getting divided into two parts on the modes of reproduction. Okay, on the modes of the reproduction, the plants are getting divided into two categories. Some plants are there which get asexually reproduce, while the others get reproduce sexually. Okay, so now what is mean by asexual and sexual? Next one. So let's discuss the definition. So the plants which can reproduce without seed. Okay, what? Without seed. Okay, The plants which can get reproduced without use of the seed or without seed, then that type of the reproduction is called as what? Asexual reproduction. Next one, the plants which can get reproduced by the use of seed. What? Use of seed. Okay, then that type of the reproduction is called as what? Sexual reproduction. So, very important thing, student, you have to keep in the mind is that what? The asexual reproduction, there is no need of seed. Okay, without seed, we can reproduce the new plant. But in a sexual reproduction, there is a need of the seed. With the use of a seed only, we can produce a new plant. So, these are the two important things you have to keep in mind. In the sexual reproduction, there is a no need of the seed. But in a sexual reproduction, there is a need of a seed. Without seed, we cannot produce a plant. Okay. So, these are the two modes of the reproduction, that are asexual reproduction and a sexual reproduction. Among these, first we are going to discuss about the asexual reproduction. So, this asexual reproduction again having certain part types, okay, that are vegetative propagation, fragmentation, budding and spore formation. Among these, all these we are going to see deeply one by one. So, today we will start with the first method of asexual reproduction, that is nothing but what? Vegetative propagation. Okay, now what is mean by vegetative propagation? So, as we know, we have discussed just now, that is what? Roots, stem, leaves, buds, all these are the parts of a plant which helps the plant to grow as a vegetative, or all these are the parts of a plant which are helps to give the vegetative growth of the plant, and that is the reason these parts of a plant are called as what? Vegetative parts. Okay. So, in this vegetative propagation, what happens? The reproduction takes place with the help of these vegetative parts. Okay, which are the vegetative parts? Roots, stem, leaves, and buds. Okay, so the reproduction takes place with the help of these all vegetative parts. Then that type of a reproduction is called as what? Vegetative propagation. What? Vegetative propagation. Why? Because vegetative parts are used for the reproduction, that is the reason that production is called as what? Reproduction is called as what? Vegetative propagation. So, let's discuss what is my exactly vegetative propagation. So, if you see about the stem, first we discuss the vegetative propagation with the help of the stem. So, as we know in the stem, there are so many things are present, okay? So, now here I will draw one diagram. So, on the stem, here where the leaves arise, okay? Or where on the stem where the leaves arise, that portion is called as what? Node. Okay, that portion is called as node. N-O-D-E, node. Okay, so we have to do one activity. We have to take one cutting. Okay, that cutting should contain the node. And that cutting, you have to put it into the soil for the certain days. You have to water that cutting. And after a certain period of time, you can see that that cutting can grow into a new plant, but it will take a certain time. That for period, time period, you have to you have to observe. Okay, so in this way, these with the help of the cutting, so we can grow the new plant. Cutting means that we are taking the stem or the branch. Okay, so with the help of this cutting, means what? With the help of the stem, also we can grow the new plant. Especially, we can say that what? Money plant, rose, we can grow with the help of this cutting method. Okay. So, this is about what? Stem. But very important thing is that, as you know, there are the buds present on a flower, on a plant. Okay. So, there are the different types of the buds are present. First one is what? Flower bud. Flower bud means what? The bud is there which get converts into the flowers. Okay. But along with this flower bud, there are the other two buds are present on a plant that you have seen in your 6th standard also. That is what? Apical bud and the auxiliary bud. Okay, auxiliary bud. Okay, apical bud and the auxiliary bud. So, this apical bud helps for the vertical growth, while this auxiliary bud helps for the lateral growth, means sideway growth is helpful for this auxiliary bud. With the help of this auxiliary bud, the plants can show the lateral growth. Okay, now where is this auxiliary bud is present? So, this auxiliary bud is present in between the node and the stem. In between the node and the stem. Very important. Keep in the mind. Where is the bud present? Auxiliary bud present? Near to the node. At the lower portion of the node and to the stem. Between the stem and the node, there is a bud present which is called as what? Auxiliary bud, which helps for the vegetative growth of the plant. Okay? So this is the first part of vegetative propagation we have discussed, that is about what? Stem. Now some plants are there which can grow with the help of the buds. The very well known example you have seen the potato. You can see in the image also how exactly it is potato. Okay. So on the potato we can see the scars are there or the buds are there, and then buds also we are calling as what? Eye of potato. So if you separate that each bud and if you sow into the soil, and after certain period or after certain days, that each bud will grow into the new plant. Okay. So with the help of these buds, we can grow the new plant. That buds are also called as what? Eye. That buds are also called as what? Eye. Okay. So these are the different types of the bud. One is what? Flower bud we have seen, and next one what? Vegetative buds, which helps to grow the plant. Next one we will discuss that with the help of the roots. So there are the certain plants, for example we can say that what? Sweet potato is there. Okay. Or this sweet potato can grow with the help of the root. We can reproduce the sweet potato with the help of the roots. Next one we can discuss that also we can reproduce the plants with the help of the leaves. And well known example, that is what? Bryophyllum. You can see in the picture how exactly the bryophyllum is. So as you know, as you can see in the image, on the margin of a bryophyllum leaf there are the buds present, and when these buds fallen into the moist soil, then that started to grow as a new plants. Okay. Also some plants are like a cactus plant. How they reproduce? When there are certain parts of a plant get detached from the main plant, then that fallen part or the detached part of a plant can grow as a new plants. Okay. So in this way, what we have discussed, this vegetative parts of a plant helps to reproduce the plant, and that method of asexual reproduction is called as what? Vegetative propagation. Okay. So see, in this vegetative propagation, the new individual, the new plants will form, that will be the exact copy of their parents. Okay? It will look almost similar to like a parents. Also with the reproduction takes place with the help of the vegetative propagation, takes the less time to grow the plants as compared to the reproduction which takes place with the help of the seed. Okay, means if we do the reproduction with the help of this vegetative propagation, then the plants will grow more fastly or their growth will be more rapid as compared to the reproduction of a plant with the help of a seed. Okay. So this is all about vegetative propagation and about what? This is the first method of asexual reproduction. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. Today we have discussed about reproduction, modes of reproduction, asexual and sexual, and in asexual reproduction we have discussed about the vegetative propagation. Okay, so remaining methods we will discuss in the next video, and for today, thank you.